Actually, many were requesting a video about like how we can resume the train model. For example, like okay, here I have trained my model and I train for 100 epochs. Okay, I will just go inside my project main, and to find the model, we have to go inside assets and weights. I trained a Neil Tyson model. Again, I just trained for this video. I trained 100 epochs, but now I want to train for 250 epochs. Then you will feel bad that, okay, if I want to train it again, then I need to start from 0 to 250. But how we can resume? How I can resume from 100 epochs to 250 epochs or 500 epochs? So in this video, we'll see that how we can train our model using the pre-trained values. Okay, for that, just first, as same, like go on, connect the runtime. Okay, I'm just connecting the runtime. Okay. Hope it's recording. Okay. And I need to, okay, once this is connected, then as usual, I need to run to Google Drive. Just give all this, all these things as same. Okay, connect to Google Drive and give your account. Hello. Okay, it will just take some time, so I'm just skipping this part. So now it's done. The install to Google Drive part is done. Okay, once this is done, just go and we need to give the, we need to see, don't run any of this. Don't run pre-process, don't run extra feature, don't run train index, directly come for train model, because already we have everything. We just need to continue to train the model. So in train model, first we need to give the auth token. I already have my auth token over here. Yeah, I'm just giving you, just give your token. Then we need to give the model name, the same name that we kept, right? We need to give the same name. Don't change any name. So Neil model, like before, when you train this model, you kept a name, right? So give the same exact name. Okay. I just already trained until 100 epochs. So now I want to train until 250. Actually, when I'm just giving 250, right? Which means it will start from 100 and it will stop at 250. It is not that 100 plus 250. It will eliminate that first 100. And it will run from 100 to 250, 100 to 250. So don't think that it is 100 plus 250. It will start from 100 and it will run the remaining 150 part. So it will ends with 250 epochs. Okay. Okay. So now what I have to do is I just need to go inside this code. You just click this icon so that it will open the code. So once you go inside this code, the down part, the last part, when you come, we can see there are two things it is using to train your model. Actually, this is the place where it is training your model. So don't need to look at all this code. Don't need to change anything. Just come here. Here it is using this two like a PTH file, right? Instead of this two PTH file, we need to give another two PTH file. So for that, go inside your drive folder and go inside my drive. Here we need to go inside this project main. Now go inside logs folder, and inside logs folder you will see all the model that you have created. Now I'm just want to like resume the Neil model, right? So I'm just going inside that Neil model. Inside this Neil model, see here I can see there are two PTH file. Here you can see they are using F0G40 PTH, right? Here start with G, right? The same G you can see here, but it is different G, something else. So copy this path. And instead of this, you paste it this one. Instead of this path, you paste that path inside the quotation. Don't remove the quotation. So inside the quotation, instead of that old path, I am pasting this path. And here, see, it is using D40. Instead of this D40, we need to copy this path, this D part. So copy this one. And inside the quotation, paste. Don't remove the quotation or it will show an error. Okay. Now the process is done. Now the things are done, just we need to run the code. Okay, I'm just closing this and running. Okay, Now you can see it shows an error. What error it shows? It shows failed to launch tensor board. Actually, if you follow the comments of the old video, there itself I fixed this error. Actually, this error is mainly caused because of the NumPy version, different NumPy version. Just click the code and just move this code above. That's why I last video itself I said whenever you are using this, whenever you are writing a new NumPy version, save that file so that in the next time when you are loading it, you can use this without an error. What you need to do is you just put first of e and pip space install numpy equal to 1.23.5. You need to install this numpy version. The old version that it is installing using the requirement file is not matching anymore, so we need to install this version. Now it will show some warning message. Just ignore this warning message and just run this train model. Okay, now you can see that it starts without showing an error. So let's see that whether it is resuming or not. Okay, here we can see that it is just loading these two files. It is, see, when it is loading itself, it is already saying that it is under epochs. So which means it knows that, okay, it these two files have the memory of 100 epochs. So already these two files stores the weightage. Actually, there is something called weight in deep learning. So those weights are nothing but that is some mathematical calculation which is used for this model training and all these things. So it is showing that this contain the weights until 100 epochs, which means we can resume the process from 100 epochs. So let's see that whether this is resuming from 100 epochs or not. Okay, see, now even when we are loading itself, it is saying that it is saving model and it is optimizer state at 100 epochs. So actually when this model is loading, it's saving in new values to this D and G and it is storing at 100 epochs. And see, now it is starting from 100 epochs, 101, 102. So it will just go on until 250. Actually, why it is taking less time? It is because since it is a tutorial video, I just used only one audio file for 1 minute to train this 100 epochs. So that's why it is doing the same. Actually, now it is using the data set that you already uploaded, which means when you are resuming that your training process, right, you don't need to upload the data set again with all the audio files. You just need to install the Google Drive part and after that directly come to train model and just train, because it already have the memory and weightage of the training data set that you already gave. So it will use that old weightage and it will just resume the training process. You don't need to give a new database here. Okay, by this way that we can resume our training model. So if you have any doubts or something, then you can just put it in the command box. Then I will reply to that command and I will say how to fix. And if you can't even solve using by following the command, then I will just post it as a video so that it will be easier for you to fix those errors.